Hey, what's going on, everyone? We're going to be talking about some shoulder impingement today. I'm here with my wife, Nast. Nast has had a history of shoulder issues before. She did track and field in college, javelin, cranked her shoulder, had some rotator cuff issues, and it pops up if we're not careful. So one of the amazing things about human beings is that we're able to compensate to achieve a task. One of the bad things about human beings in our bodies is that we're able to compensate to achieve a task. So our shoulders are able to compensate to a certain amount, and then eventually your shoulder gets mad, and you might get some pinching feeling going on. Pinching is nothing that you're necessarily gonna resolve with stretching for the most part. And so we're gonna go over a quick series of exercises that you can try 3, 4, maybe 5 rounds of before you go overhead in a workout to see how it feels. Now, if it still pinches when you go overhead, do not do overhead movements while you do, if you still have that pinch, okay? You can adjust the range of motion. You can adjust it by going incline. You can go horizontal. Adjust it. Just because the workout calls for pressing overhead, if your shoulder gets worse, you're not gonna be able to press overhead at all, all right? This video, what we're about to go over with these exercises is not for if we go to do the shoulder abduction test and you're like, pinch, okay? This is if you're near that top range and it's just a little bit right there. When you warm up, it might feel better. This is something for you to help kind of increase that range of motion. I'm not sure about the exact technical way to say this, but kind of recenter the shoulder joint so you can clear that edge when we press up overhead. So the first thing we're gonna do is some horizontal band work. Nast is gonna grab this band, all right? It doesn't need to be super tense. She's gonna internally rotate a little bit so that thumb's gonna be pulled down. And as she pulls across, she'll no longer be internally rotated. So go ahead, pull it across. We're gonna do 10 reps of this. And what we're trying to do is have that scapula move freely. Don't think about pinning that shoulder back. Just think about coming across and reach for the other side of the room. So let's pretend like she just did 10 reps. She's gonna turn around, do 10 reps on the other side. All right, again, 10 reps either way. Do one more for me, nice and slow and controlled. Don't yank it. When she gets done with 10 reps, this is our corrective exercise for today. She is now gonna hop up on the pull-up bar. Now, we're not hanging from the pull-up bar. We're gonna learn how to load and tension a little bit through the shoulder because we did corrective action exercise. And now we're gonna do something to try and increase that range of motion. She's gonna grab one arm only, chin up grip. She's gonna brace, breathe, and she's gonna go into the best range of motion she can with that shoulder. The goal is to try and keep that bicep by the ear. You don't have to exaggerate it and pull it behind your head, but this should be pain-free range of motion. So if you feel a pinch there, stop. Stay in a pain-free range of motion. What you can't tell is that she's putting pressure downwards and back, right? This direction as she goes into the stretch, okay? And she's gonna end up doing 10 reps of this. Let's pretend like she did 10. Let's pretend like she did 10 on the other arm. Once she gets done with that, we have a lightish kettlebell. Light is depending on the person. She's gonna load up this kettlebell. Go ahead, pick it up. Let's load up that shoulder. We'll get it overhead. And her goal is to be pain-free in this as well. So her core is gonna be on. She's gonna be reaching overhead. She's gonna walk for 60 feet down and back per arm, okay? 50 to 60 feet. Doesn't need to be super heavy. Again, this should not pinch or hurt the shoulder. This is not designed for people that have severe impingement. You have a torn rotator cuff, something like that. This is for people that you might have this little nag every once in a while, especially if you just did a bunch of push-ups or pull-ups, it gets tight on you. We're gonna go through this series 3 to 5 times, increasing the shoulder range of motion, and you can relax, okay? So again, 3 rounds, work your way up to 5 rounds if it helps you. You can start laying that dumbbell. We're gonna go 10 horizontal band pulls, 10 per arm, 10 times breathing and bracing into that overhead stretch, pain-free range of motion, and then 50 to 60 feet, one arm overhead carry, back and forth. You can start really light, load up more as your shoulder range of motion gets better. Try that out, I hope it helps you out. I know there's so many people that have a slight pinch in your shoulder. Maybe you're part of that 5% of the world that maybe you can never really stop that pinch. Let's try this out, hope it works for you. Love to hear how you do. Please share and comment. Talk to you guys soon.